Yeah, that was John Waite with The Missing You, a huge hit in the 1980s.
Huge
newest CD.
Now I know.
Temple Bar is an autobiographical collection of songs based on events that inspired him to become a singer when he was a working class youth growing up in Lancaster, England. Yeah, he's had quite a life, quite a career. Here's John Waite, everybody. John Waite, the Temple Bar here.
Yes.
Now, you planned this cover to be just the way it is. Kathy was wondering.
It draws your attention.
Well, it was getting out of hand, actually. And there's an old Rolling Stones album called Beggar's Banquet.
Mm-hmm.
So the shortest way through the problem was to...
just give you a blank page and put the name on right
there. That's right.
Very good.
Yeah.
But you know, John, you've been around for a while, huh?
Yeah.
Remember John?
What are you trying to say?
Well... Remember John in The Babies?
But you look real good. Don't worry about it.
I wear it well.
It's just that John was a member of The Babies not too long ago.
Well, that's a while.
Which one is John? Right there.
No.
Well, this one right here, right?
This is this one. No, it's this one.
John having fun with the stupid host.
Who's not even from the South.
Hey.
I thought I had it. Am I right?
Yeah, that's
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah,
that's
sure.
Me.
And what year was this?
That's about 1976.
Gee, this guy looks so familiar to me. The one...
He was in Rod Stewart's band.
Oh, was he?
That's why. He was all the
concerts. That's why I remember him, yeah.
Yeah. Disco.
When he wasn't seeing Def Leppard, he was seeing him.
Yeah. And The Babies on the Edge.
Yeah, that was our last one. That was the last thing we did together.
Were you a happy group together?
Not towards the end, but I think most bands just explode after about 5 years.
Oh, absolutely. I don't know how some of them go year after year beyond that.
Well, it's a very tough life, I think, and you're in each other's pockets all the time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So.
Now, there are a lot of kids out there going, tough life?
Yeah, it's
very
grueling.
You got the money, grueling.
There is money, but I mean, you travel all the time, you're away from home, it's very hard to keep anything together.
You get on each other's nerves.
That too. You know, you need a day job or something. It's a very rough life. It is a rough life.
It's an unreal life, isn't it? There's absolutely very little reality.
It's hard to keep your feet on the ground, I think.
Mm. And then Bad English, was that the second group you were a part of?
Well, yeah, I was solo in the middle of this. That's where Missing You came from.
Yeah.
What you just heard. And then I joined this band. It was half of Journey and half of The Babies.
Mm-hmm. I see.
Yeah.
I see. And now, single time, right?
Yeah.
How do you like that?
I like it better. It's less complicated.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
You can only blame yourself or applaud,
huh? Yeah, right. Yeah, I prefer it.
Do you write your songs too, John?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's three covers on the album. There's a Hank Williams song and Bill Withers. And...
oh, I love the Bill Withers. I haven't heard that in a long time. You know, sunshine when she's gone. Yeah. But you'd only heard it the Bill Withers way because it was such a standard.
Well, actually, I heard Michael Jackson's version.
I hadn't heard his, but...
when it was the Jacksons. When I was about 18, he released it.
Perry Como had a release on that, too. I used to love Perry's version of it.
No, it's really terrific.
Thanks.
So, but you're not married.
I'm divorced.
Oh, you are?
Yeah.
How long have you been divorced?
About 7 years.
7 years?
Mm. So
usually, you know, there's a rebound period there where you jump into the next marriage or...
Well, no, I lived with somebody for about 6 years after that.
Oh, I see. Still?
Yeah. No.
No.
No. Now it says he's looking for Mrs.
All of a sudden, I think we need Stuart Smalley out here.
That would have been funny.
So are you actively looking for Mrs. Wright?
Yeah, I don't think you ever really stopped, but I got my hands full at the moment with the album, so I'm sort of...
that's good.
Just working.
Deep in your work, huh?
Yeah.
But if she did come along?
I'd get married and have kids, yeah, I'd probably quit.
Really? Do you not think they can live side by side?
No, you're away from home too much. I mean, that's what was wrong the first time, I think. I was always going away on tour.
Well,
always making records.
Is there
somewhere else?
A certain type of lady you'd like to meet?
Well, if somebody likes to travel.
I thought we were giving it up for a minute.
Yeah.
Now, the new CD is autobiographical, right? Where did the title come from?
Temple Bar is actually a bar downtown.
Here in New York?
Yeah. And when I was writing the record, I would go for these long walks and make notes and wind up in the Temple Bar for a glass of wine at the end of the day. And more, the images became like cinematic and more drawn from that situation. And I turned 40 right in the middle of the record, so it was quite a heavy record to make.
So you're an Englishman, but you spent some time here in New York City.
Yeah, I live in Manhattan now. I got a green card and everything.
Well, that makes you different from a lot of people here.
Well, no, come on. It's
Thank
handy.
You.
I'm laughing. It was funny. Anybody ever ask you for that green card?
It's pink, actually.
Well, is it pink?
Does anybody ever want to see it?
No. It's like a driver's license, but, you know, I don't carry it around with me.
Yeah.
Julian says he's got one. You've got one, Julian?
No, he doesn't.
You English?
I've got a gold card.
He's got a
gold card. You're American.
And he's paying for it. So what's your life like? I mean, you seem to be like the loner, you know, the introspective type, thinking of your next song, deep in, involved in the lyrics and melodies.
I'm a pretty upbeat guy. The album is a bit sort of introspective, yeah, but I am fairly sort of upbeat. But I think I'm a blues singer. I come from that sort of school, that English blues thing.
That working class kind of guy.
Well, yeah, but I mean, I think my style is much more sort of a blues style, and I approach music like sort of getting it off your chest, not necessarily. If I'm very happy, I don't really write music.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sure, right. All right, well, when we come back, you'll sing for us, all right?
Good.
John, wait, how did I get by without you?
Yeah,
which is what
terrific.
You should think of me.
Yeah.
I'll be back.
Tomorrow on Live, actor Emmanuel Lewis.
All right, here he is. How did I get by without you? Which is the song Kathy Lee sings to me every day. Yeah, it's Glen Burtnik
and Shane
and Fontayne. Shane Fontayne on guitars. Thank you very much for coming, guys. And here's John Waite, everybody.
There was a time when I thought I knew everything about this great big world. Till I met you into my life like a brand new start. Now I find my home inside your eyes, wherever you are. It's hard to say it, cause I hide things so good, but you make me say it like only you could. I love you more than any man could ever say. Count the ways, and I'll be here. I believe in everything you do. So how did I get by without you? In the morning light, to see you wake up next to me, it's a beautiful sight. Everything's alright. I love you, baby, let me count the ways, and I'll be here. I believe that all my dreams came true. So how did I get by without you? You love me, now I know that I'm the lucky guy. You've got me, and there's nowhere I can hide. So I'll stay here. I believe that all my dreams came true. So how did I get by without you?
Yeah! Temple Bar song right there. Johnny, thanks very much. Enjoy it. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. All the best to you.
We'll be right back in a moment with our Mother's Day weekend whirlwind.
Next week on Live, news personality Peter Jennings.